Welcome to Bharatvansh YouTube channel. Please do like, comment, share and subscribe. Don't forget to press the bell icon for more updates.
Kanva Dynasty, 75 BC to 30 BC. Kanva was a successor dynasty of the Shungas in Magadha. The rulers are known as Kanvayanas. They were Brahmin origin and considered themselves as descendants of Rishi Kanva. They ruled for a very short duration of 45 years. Their capital was Pataliputra. Vasudeva Kanva, 75 BC to 66 BC. Vasudeva Kanva was founder of the dynasty. He was a minister in the court of Devabhuti, the last Shunga ruler. He killed his master and ascended the throne. During his reign, Yavanas invaded India and had occupied Punjab region. Although Vasudeva Kanva established his rule in Magadha, he allowed Shunga descendants to rule in a small region of Vidisha. Satavahanas, the vassals of Kanvas, tried to become independent in south, but were forced to be under the suzerainty of Vasudeva Kanva. Bhumi Mitra, 66 BC to 52 BC. He was the second king of the Kanva dynasty and son of Vasudeva Kanva. He fought many wars against Satavahanas, all were victorious. Satavahanas continued to rule as vassals of Kanvas. Narayana, 52 BC to 40 BC. Bhumimitra was succeeded by his son Narayana, who ruled for 12 years. During his last years, Satavahanas tried an unsuccessful mission to become free from Kanvas. Susharman, 40 BC to 30 BC. He was son of Narayana. He was attacked and killed by Satavahana ruler. The Kanva kingdom was annexed to Satavahana empire. This put an end to Kanva dynasty. Deva dynasty, 2nd century BC to 1st century BC. After the fall of Mauryan empire, Deva dynasty carved out a kingdom and ruled independently for some time. Their capital was Saket near Ayodhya. The dynasty became a vassal state under Pushyamitra Shunga. He recognized Muladeva as his vassal of Saket region. Muladeva was succeeded by his son Mitradeva. Mitradeva tried to become free from Shunga rule and attacked many times on his master. Finally, he killed Vasumitra, the ruler of Shunga Empire, in 124 BC and declared himself independent ruler of Saket. Mitradeva was succeeded by his son Vayudeva. The successor of Vayudeva was his son Phalgunadeva. Phalgunadeva was succeeded by his son Dhanadeva. The Ayodhya inscription related to Dhanadeva gives the information about the Shunga dynasty and Pushyamitra's Ashwamedha. He ruled during 50 BC. The last ruler of the dynasty was Vishakhadeva, son of Dhanadeva. The Deva dynasty was ended with killing of the last ruler Vishakhadeva by Datta dynasty ruler. Hence, Saket was annexed by the Datta dynasty, ending the reign of Deva dynasty. Datta dynasty, 1st century BC to 1st century CE. Datta dynasty ruled for a short period after replacing Deva dynasty of Saket. Their capital was Mathura and kingdom was extended up to Ayodhya. Sheshadatta was the first recorded ruler of the dynasty. His successor Ramadatta had issued coins which had impressions of goddess Lakshmi on it. The third ruler of the dynasty was Shishuchandradatta. The last ruler of the dynasty was Shivadatta. During his reign, the kingdom was attacked and annexed by Mitra dynasty of Mathura with the help of Indo-Greek army during the beginning of 1st century CE. After the decline of Mauryans, the Shunga dynasty lost control over Kosambi, Mathura and Ayodhya regions. Mitras are said to be descendants of Pushyamitra Shunga, established independent kingdoms in three regions separately. Mitra dynasty of Mathura, 150 BC to 50 BC. This branch of Mitras ruled as vassals under Indo-Greeks of Takshila from the times of Menander I. The rulers of this dynasty were Gomitra I, Gomitra II, Brahmamitra, Dhridamitra, Suryamitra, Vishnumitra and Satyamitra. Satyamitra attacked on Datta dynasty and annexed it with the help of Yavanas. Eventually, the kingdom was annexed by Yavanas, their masters, in 50 BC. Mitra dynasty of Saket or Ayodhya, 100 BC to 350 CE. This branch of Mitras ruled in Saket or Ayodhya region during the last rulers of Shunga dynasty. They ruled as independent sovereigns till the occupation of their kingdom by Kushans. Initial independent rulers of the dynasty were Sanghamitra and Vijayamitra. Satyamitra, the next king, accepted the suzerainty of Kanishka, and his successor Devamitra also remained vassals of Kushan Empire. After the death of Kanishka, Aryamitra, the successor of Devamitra, declared independence. Kumudasena and Ajayavarma were next rulers. Samudragupta annexed the Mitra kingdom during his campaign. Mitra dynasty of Kosambi, 100 BC to 350 CE. Initial rulers of this branch of Mitras ruled simultaneously with Shungas. Their capital was Prayag, and during the reign of Vasumitra, it was shifted to Rajgriha in Magadha. The first recorded ruler of the dynasty was Shungavarma. He was succeeded by his son Vishwadeva. Agaraja was next ruler, and Dhanabhuti accepted the friendship with Shungas. Agimitra was the son of Dhanabhuti, and Jeshtamitra and Vasumitra were Agnimitra's sons, who ruled the kingdom one after the other. Brihaspati Mitra was the next ruler, and he is mentioned in the Hathi Gumpha inscription of Karavela of Mahamegavahana dynasty. He was defeated at his capital Rajgriha by Karavela. The next rulers, Radhamitra and Sarpamitra, ruled till the end of 1st century CE and issued some coins. Finally, the dynasty ended during the campaign of Samudragupta in 350 CE.
Please like, share, comment and subscribe to Bharatvansh channel. Don't forget to press the bell icon.